Going to try and do a summary about the rain, the February rain 2019. This cloud was hanging around and had been hanging around for a while. This is the 30th of January. And we'd heard reports of rain in the north and rain to the east. There was no cloud really to the south. And you could basically still see the sun going down in the west. So we were hoping, very much hoping on the 30th of January that this would come down or across. It was lovely to hear people's rainfalls, and there were still people missing out, didn't have cloud at all. Then on the 1st of February this happened. I think on this day we recorded 25 mil and it was just absolutely glorious. And those waiting for rain know that the difference between 24 and 48 hours is huge when you haven't had rain for a while. And those wanting rain to stop know that that's a long time as well. But still there was people that had not received a drop of rain or hadn't even looked like they were going to get any rain when we were receiving this. And it was just glorious, absolutely glorious, the beginning of our rain. There was already water in the lagoon, or there was the lagoon was coming up from rain that had fallen further north and was filling up the Burke system already. And the Burke on the 1st of February was 3.2 metres from the lovely rain that had occurred further north. And with the rain that we did receive, we received this huge wind. And that's what the sky looked like on the 4th of February, with massive winds. And this is the same area today after our 56 mil. So today is the 11th of February, and this is 56 mils later on stony pebbly ridges. This is the 9 mile that was taken on the 2nd of February. Bossman and I went for a drive, and we could still, it wasn't over the road. That's the 9 mile east of Boulia. And I made a point of saying that when the 9 mile gets big enough, the beautiful channel system just floods out. If it gets big enough, it will cover this area here, but that's a really, really big flood. But when the 9 mile goes over, the water will sit in these lower areas and it'll spread out, and you can see the tree line that's coming up. It'll break its banks further north, and this is looking south, and this here will be covered in water as well as part of the 9 mile when it floods out, what we call it. That beautiful cloud still around on the 4th of February. This was the Burke on the 4th of February. It had gone down a little bit. It did get up to 4.8 metres, and it goes over the bridge at 4.9. This is the Sandy on the 4th of February 2019. Of course, the Sandy comes out of the Burke further up the river. So they basically run together. The Burke and the Sandy, it's got a freshen it there. So it's coming up. And this is our, what we call the Goodwood Swamp. That's looking north, east, south to Goodwood, and there's the lagoon, the Goodwood Swamp, And that's looking out to town. That was on the 8th of February. And this is also on the 8th of February. This is Lagoon. I just love the reflections. The reflections of the trees in the water. I think they're beautiful. That's our Goodwood Swamp, what we call our lagoon, at the house. That's looking towards town. It's looking west. North, east, back to Goodwood in the south, and back around again. And this is today, the 11th of February. I thought I'd show you what a difference it makes. The lagoon's gone back down. There's still lots, fair bit of water there. But the countryside's got a tinge of green from the 8th of February to today, the 11th. There's Goodwood and there's our lagoon. That's the Goodwood Swamp. Goodwood Swamp and the lagoon. And there's town. You can see town way over there. That's town. That's Boulia.
This is the 9 mile on the 8th of February 2019. This is the Kennedy Development Road from Boulia to Winton. And this is looking east to Winton. This is what the 9 mile looks at, 0.6 meters. You can see it's backed up on the northern side of the road, the way that the water comes from. And it's far too strong. You wouldn't attempt to cross it. So it's, what happens is the Burke and the Sandy get that big, that first of all the 9 mile runs. And then if it stays at 3.6 for 12 to 24 hours, the 5 mile runs. So I just thought everybody might like to see what it looks like. This is what we call a good flood. You can see there further east, you can see that the 9 mile has broken out of its banks further up, and there's water running down on the eastern side of it as well. That's looking south. It'll go through Goodwood, just over the fence there. And then after it goes through Goodwood, it ends up down through Mudjacka and, of course, lots of other places. And you can see it's broken out of its banks on the western side as well, through those trees that I talked about earlier when Bossman and I went for a drive. But this has come out of Queen Vera. When it broke its banks, it comes through Elrose and then it comes through Queen Vera. When the 5 mile breaks, when the 5 mile starts, it starts up at Elrose as well. They're basically both together, the 9 mile and the 5 mile, but it's just that the 9 mile must be that little bit lower. And the 9 mile runs through Elrose and Queen Vera, and then the 5 mile runs through Elrose and Headford. And we just happened to Queen Vera and Headford are two of our blocks, so we benefit from this water. And of course Mudjacka benefits from the 9 mile and the 5 mile as well. That's just a little bit higher, show you how it spreads out. So we're very privileged, really, because if we don't get the rain and other people in the north get the rain, it can rain 150 kilometres to the north. And if it rains enough up there and our Burke system is full enough and these systems flow, the 9 mile and the 5 mile flow, even if the 9 mile flows, it's still benefit to us. It still helps us. But this time we did get absolutely wonderful rain for a start, and we got this lovely flood as well. So we truly are very lucky to have this beautiful water, precious water, watering these trees, watering the environment, making it nice and healthy. If a really, really big flood happens, all that dry country that you can see there, it will go under. Basically, the 5 mile and the 9 mile join up together. It's amazing to see. I've only ever seen it once. I didn't own a drone back then, but it still was incredible to see. The water isn't all that deep, but it does crawl across the ground. It is amazing to see. And that's that tree line there. Now you know why the trees are where they are. People sometimes think that we've come along with bulldozers and chains and everything and taken the trees away. But the trees are where they are because that's where the water lies the most. I dared myself to take Dame Drone across the top of the water or closer to the water. I was very, very nervous, I must admit. And I fastened this up a bit to show you. But I've slowed it down as well to show you how fast the water is running across the road at 0.6.
And this is the 5 mile. Well, that's not the 5 mile, but the one over further over, that's the 5 mile. And this is just showing how it spreads out. So the Burke and the Sandy let the 9 mile run first and then the 5 mile. So this is just spreading out from the 5 mile. The little causeways along the way from Boulia out to the 9 mile, they're all flowing. You can see the water flowing there. Not all of them flowed this time, but enough to say that it was a good flood. And this is the Goodwood Swamp on the bitumen. So I videoed it near the house and what we call the lagoon. And this is what the Goodwood Swamp looks like. It was 0.4 here. This is what the Goodwood Swamp looks like at the bitumen. So that's the Sandy, the first lot of, you can see that first creek and the Burke's on the other side. And that's to the north. That's where all it splits up. And it comes down and it flows to the south. It's the lagoon. You can see the Sandy there, the creek. And there's town. And the Burke River is right next to town. And this was what the ground looked like. The green coming up already on the 8th of February. There's little bits of green coming up. We'd had a couple of days of sunshine by this. I think this was our second day of sunshine of the rain. There's the Goodwood Swamp, Coolbrooker Road. This is the photo that I took of the lagoon near the house on the 4th of February. And this is what it looks like today on the 11th of February. And this is a pigsty. Now the water came up level with the pigsty when it was at its peak. And you can see the tree. That tree behind is the one that I've used to gauge. There's Junior. That was on the 4th with the cloud and the dirty water, and he's enjoying himself. And here he is today, the 11th. After a game of ball, we went down for a swim.